Salute, salute, Talk Nation. Welcome back, everybody. Thank you for joining me for another episode. Disappointing. Eagles fall to the New York Giants. Salty. And you know what? I got to be a man of my own words because just got finished telling somebody who made a comment on the first Philadelphia Eagles and New York Giants video that I just did. Go back and check it out after you finish watching this video from bumper to bumper. Thank you for joining me once again. But I told him, you got to ride with your team no matter what. And he said, you know what? I can respect that. And definitely tough loss. Eagles couldn't get it going. Giants did get it going. Go back, like I said in the other video. Okay? And that's tough. But like I said, you got to ride with your squad. Can the Eagles get it together? Yes. Every team they play, from I believe the next five games out, we play the Browns next, all these teams are over 500. So are we and can we elevate our game to not only be competitive, but to secure the wins? Because will we win all these games coming up? I would like to say I hope so. You know what I mean? But I cannot definitively say, yes, we will. You know what I mean? Got to be realistic. Like I said, my fanalysis, not analysis, my fanalysis, remember where y'all heard it first, it's your boy. My fanalysis of the subject, you want your team to win every game. You say they're going to win every game, but you have to be realistic. Browns are playing very well. So it is going to be tough to get that victory. The Eagles' offense, defense are going to not only have to be consistent, but they're going to have to raise their game. Our defense has been carrying us. So if our defense fluctuates or have a bad game, we are in trouble. It's already been proven. So Carson Wentz, like I said, he's going to have to start picking it up and carrying his team forward, not backwards, not to the middle, but past the finish line. He has to start putting these games and his team on his shoulders. Couldn't get it done. Our run game was decent. Shout out to Miles Sanders. Welcome back, Boston Scott, doing this thing, one touchdown. Look, we have to not only, like I said, be consistent, we have to always be on point. We cannot afford to have any lapses in judgment and definitely any lapses in energy. We have to come out and have to give 110% every down, every quarter of each game. We have to start getting it done. You hear chants, especially if you look at the comment feeds about fire Doug Peterson. Look, that's not going to happen. First of all, like I told you guys, all the struggles that not only the Philadelphia Eagles, but a lot of teams are having this season, all of these things are being taken into account, not only by ownership, but throughout the league, through analysts and commentators. But people have to talk about what people have to talk about. But once you look past all the BS, that's why I told you guys, here, we're not going to bring you stats. We're going to bring you the heart of the city, the heart of the team, and the heart of the player. It's a lot going on. Now, are these excuses? I won't necessarily say so, but these are a reality. Now, the Eagles are going to have to, like I said, step it up, get the job done, because the Browns are playing very well. And for us to go in there and be successful, we have to beat them. Not only figuratively as far as getting a W, but we have to beat their game plan. Our game plan has not been ironclad, hasn't been solid. So whether it's the game plan not being solid or the game plan not being executed, either way you look at it, it's not getting done. Either way you look at it, they both have to be improved. Because if not, all that tanking stuff, not going to talk about that. but we're going to wind up being last in the division. And that's not good, because the whole division is already struggling. And the only team in our division that is starting to show consistency and improvement, and consistent improvement, I guess, over the last three games, is the New York Giants. So if they go and they beat their next opponent and we lose to our next opponent, they can mess around and steal the division. It's that simple. And I believe once they win the division, if they win the division, it's going to be hard to take them out that spot, because their momentum is rolling. And it really doesn't show that they're showing any signs of it fluctuating. And that's to be respected. So you have to give a shout out to their coaching staff, to their players, to their young quarterback who's stepping up. You know what I mean? So Carson has to start playing and acting like the veteran that he is. Period. You can't, no, I mean, it's no more your rookie. No. You are the quarterback of the franchise. You have to start going out there and executing and playing like you are. If you don't get it done and you still do these things, end of the day, nobody's mad at you. But if you're not playing up to your full potential, and on top of that, you are consistently making the same mistakes, that's on you. That's on you. Doug Peterson, nobody can turn that around. That is going to have to come from within you. So the Philadelphia Eagles did not get it done against the New York Giants. But salute to the Giants. You know what I'm saying? Salute to the Giants. They were the bigger man, the bigger team of this game. So, can we get it done against the Browns? I hope so. I would like to believe so. But because of what has been shown, you have to be a bit optimistic. But as a fan, my analysis, ladies and gentlemen, you still got to ride with your team. Because guess what? There's still football to be played. There's still games to be won. And as long as there's games to be won and football to be played, we have a chance.